The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1933, Butterfly Chart in Excel. Well, every time I'm doing one of my Power Excel seminars, I walk around the room beforehand to see if people have any specific questions. And a guy named Eric said, hey, I need to create a butterfly chart in Excel. I'm thinking, a butterfly chart? What the heck is a butterfly chart? I mean, is he thinking about some sort of an XY scatter chart in the shape of a butterfly? I'd never heard of the terms butterfly chart. I said, Eric, tell me more about what you're trying to do. And he described something that I know, or what I call as a paired bar chart. And I said, hey, you know, starting in Excel 2010, we have a great way to do that using not a regular chart, not an XY chart, but conditional formatting. So he wanted to compare both pounds and dollars for these categories. And so I built a little table over here to grab those values. So the category is going to go down the middle. On the left-hand side, we're going to have pounds, so equal B2, and on the right-hand side, dollars, like that. All right, we'll copy that whole thing down through our data set. And then over here on the right-hand side, I'm going to create the right side of the butterfly chart by using home, conditional formatting, and a data bar, and we'll just choose data, you know, any color like that. And then here's the thing. Now, we could have done this part in Excel 2007, but there's one important setting that was not available. So, conditional formatting, data bars, and choose a different color for the left side. All right, but that, Eric said, no, that's not what I need. I need the things on the left-hand side to start from the middle. And I said, yeah, that's the beautiful thing here. So, we go to conditional formatting, manage rules, and edit this rule. And starting in Excel 2010, there's this thing called bar direction, where we can change from context to right to left. All right, and then also for both sides, we're going to choose show bar only. Click OK. Click OK, and then same thing over here. Select those, manage rules. On the right-hand side, they're already going the right direction. We just want to say show bar only. Click OK. Click OK. All right, so now we have the various categories, and you can see the various amounts going in two sides, kind of like a butterfly. That's why he called it a butterfly chart. I've seen this before as a paired bar chart, where I know I have it in one of my books, the Charts and Graphs book, where we have different flavors of ice cream, and then male and female, or it was actually adults and kids. So, you know, the kids tend to like the simple flavors, whereas the adults were going after the more complex flavors, and so that allowed you to show those two sets of percentages. The interesting thing here is, even though that these numbers are different orders of magnitude, you can still kind of get a sense for you know, which items have the largest magnitude. Like for some reason down here, there's a lot of pounds, but not a lot of dollars in those products. So you can kind of spot those anomalies. So there you go for Eric in Miami, how to create a butterfly chart in Excel. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from MrExcel.com.